Most of the guys that buy my book are the older guys are guys who've never been married, and for whatever reason, they've never gotten married. They come to the workshops, and the girls know. Women can tell almost immediately you're not dating. Let's start with that. So when you're 40 years old, and you have to start at the bottom of the age ladder, top of the beauty scale, and you have to start dating. So that'll get rid of that problem. But when you've never been married, you have to be truthful and you have to answer the question diplomatically. And all the women say the same thing, that the answer they can live with is, I've been very busy with my career. That they can understand. I get a lot of computer geeks. I get a lot of lawyers, doctors, dentists, engineers, high-paid people who took a lot of schooling and they got out of the groove. I have one doctor who is 35 now, and he hadn't been kissed, he was 30. But he is the poster boy for my program. He's now, let's see, I think he's dating 5 different women.
Wow.
So, he did everything I told him. He didn't flinch, he didn't ask why, he just did it. So, it can be done. It's not a quick fix. I don't sell quick fixes, I sell reality. I teach men what I learned as a junior and in junior high school and high school and college, and being single for 12 years after I got divorced the first time. I'm teaching you all that that I learned the hard way. There was no book I could go read and find out. I just had to go out there and do it. I wrote it down. Mostly the good thing about my book is I tell you about all my mistakes, so you don't have to go make the same mistakes I did. Most men insist on making the same mistakes I did, no matter if they've read my book or not, because they just don't believe that's true. And they always write to me and say, yeah, you were right. But that's the way men are. They just they hate listening to another man. That's why I started having women in the workshops. And I don't do much. I'm kind of like a traffic director. And I just let the girls do it. They've never read any of my books, and it sounds like they're quoting chapter and verse from my books. So, but when the girls say it, beautiful, like I have Sunny, if you go to my YouTube, Steel Balls Press, all one word, and look at this babe. She's a woman I met playing poker with. And she's very good, and she's beautiful. And when she tells you that you've got to lose weight, she ain't kidding. And you can tell she's not kidding. You're not getting on top of me with a belly like that, is how she says it. So, all the people who are self-deceived about my line and says you've got to be slim and trim can just quit worrying about it. It's true. Women do not want you laying on them when you're fat. You don't have to be. You don't have to look like a men's health guy. You just have to be slim and trim. You can't be saggy and you can't be fat, period.
What's the main difference between someone who's 25 and someone who's 65 going to the same girl?
Well, if you're, let's don't make it 65, because there aren't very many guys 65 going to buy my book. I would say there aren't going to be very many 50-year-olds buy my book, so let's keep it around 40s.
Okay.
The difference between being 40 trying to go out with a 20-year-old and the difference between being 25 trying to go out with a 20-year-old is the 25-year-old guy has about 400 times as many women to choose from as the 45-year-old guy does. Because women in the 18 to 24 age group, only about 10% of them are interested in an older guy. Right? Only about 10%. And of those 10%, you're going to screw it up with half of them. So you're down to 5% right out of the chute. Okay? This is not easy, guys. This is very difficult. So even finding a young woman who will talk with you in a sensual way is very time-consuming. And you have to be willing to dedicate yourself to this 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. You have to be on the hunt. You have to always be looking. You have to always be talking. You have to always be friendly. And you have to always be outgoing. You have to go to every wedding you can get invited to. You have to have parties on your own. You have to get a circle of friends who are under 30. And start having parties and start going to their parties and start learning how to be around young people. You cannot walk, buy my book, and go out and talk to a 20-year-old. It's not going to happen. You have to get into her mind space by being around young women. And in the beginning, you're not going to be you're not going to be relaxed. You're going to be excited and you're going to be scared. And you're going to think they have something special. The only thing they have is less birthdays than you, and they have a lot different agenda than a woman that's 25, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30. The women that are 29 to 39 have an entirely different agenda than a girl between 18 to 24. So a girl between 18 and 24 that wants to go out with a 40-year-old and up man has A, the brain power to think about it and make up her own mind. B, she's had her fill with boys. That's the case with most of these young women I've ever dated. They're just sick of boys. And with their drinking and their carousing and screwing their girlfriends and lying about it and not being reliable, not being dependable, never having any money, never going anywhere, wants a blowjob all the time, you name it, they're sick of it. And they're the ones that are interested in an older man because they've already found out that boys aren't where it's at. And that takes some brain power all by itself to figure that out. So the best young woman you can look for is a working co-ed. That's someone that's going to college and she's working for a living, because what that means is she understands the real world. She knows what money is, and she's not one of these, we have in Whittier here, we have a place called Friendly Hills, which is where all the rich people are. And she's not daddy's little girl who has a BMW when she graduates from high school. You have no chance with her in a billion years. Not going to happen. Because she's going to get married to some guy 3 or 5 years older than her, and they're going to go have a honeymoon in Hawaii. She's going to get pregnant and be divorced by the time she's 28. And those women are just not anywhere interested in you because they have this mindset of the way life is and the way it's supposed to be. So that's narrows the field dramatically between the women that you have a shot at. So I always recommend being around a college somewhere. Here in Whittier, we have Whittier College on one end of town and Rio Hondo Junior College on the other end of town. If you're around a college and you live anywhere near a college and you hang out in the coffee houses, the restaurants, and whatever around a college where you can meet people. Like here in Whittier, we have the Coffee Bean, which is 2 blocks from the college. We have Mimo's Diner, which is 3 blocks from the college. And Rocky Cola Cafe, which is a 50s diner about 2 blocks from the college. California Grill, etc. That's where you meet some of them as waitresses or hostesses. You don't meet them when they're sitting there. It doesn't happen very often. It happens, but it's pretty rare. So you want to position yourself around a college so you're going to get a shot at a working co-ed. They are independent. They understand money. And daddy's not supporting them. So, oh yeah. When you're starting out on this quest, you can go down. I wrote my book. I had to go all the way down to 18-year-olds. They're just boring as shit, tell you the truth. Well, no, there were two. I'm sorry. There were two that were just dynamite, but they were super bright. Super, super bright. One girl had an IQ of 180.
Wow.
Yeah. I mean, I taught her to play backgammon, and then in 2 weeks, she beat me 13 in a row, and I said, okay, we're not going to play anymore. So, I mean, brain power makes up for age, but generally 22 and up for young women, because they're done with boys usually by then. This particular 18-year-old was just a wild child, man. She was the wildest girl I ever met. She broke my pelvis on the first date. And she only weighed 100 pounds. That's hard to do, but she had a good time trying. So they're as rare as they are beautiful, but generally 22-year-olds, and if she's average looking, like the best girlfriend I ever had was a 7 on her best day. Her name is Carla in the book. I dedicated the book to her. She was the cashier at Bob's Big Boy right down the street from me. And she was done with boys. She was 19. She was going to UCLA. She put herself through UCLA. She was a foster child at 14. She was independent, tough, strong, smart. And the bad news was she had a boyfriend who was a linebacker for UCLA, so I had to be very, very, very careful, and she had to be very, very careful, because we did not want to die. But that lasted 3 years. Oh, the other thing, guys, don't let me forget, they all have a boyfriend. Every single one of them have a boyfriend, period. Get used to it. Deal with it. That's the way it is. can't be fixed. If you find one that doesn't have a boyfriend, she is not interested in a 40-year-old man. She wants a boyfriend her age that she can show her girlfriends, I'm not a failure. So, accept the reality. They all have boyfriends. It's a whole chapter. Boyfriends, the different kinds of boyfriends, the kind of boyfriend you have a best shot with while he's there.